In our previous session, we have learned about the chemical reactions and how to represent those reactions in the chemical equations, and which are the other what we call the points, like a solid, liquid, which are going to enhance the representation of the chemical equations we have learned. In today's session, we are going to learn about the balancing of chemical equations. Already you people have learned about these things in your 8th standard, but as it is there in the syllabus, we are going to learn about those things. Before going into the balancing, why we have to balance the equation? So in the last session also we have a little bit of a discussion we have done. As we know that according to the law of conservation of mass, mass neither be created nor be destroyed. So the transformed whatever the mass it is there, it is equivalent to how much amount of the reactants which are involved in the reaction. And if we have given, we know that reactants means what? The chemicals which are going to involve in the chemical reaction, and the product, it is the end product which is formed over there at the end. So I'll write out one example on the board now. That is magnesium plus oxygen. It's going to form magnesium oxide. And if we see the equation, as we know that magnesium only one atom is there, oxygen two atoms are there. On the right hand side, that is the product side, only one oxygen is there. But we cannot make it out as a two, because the product which is formed, it is a magnesium oxide, that is a monoxide. Then according to the law of conservation of mass, we have to balance it. So as we see that magnesium, where magnesium one is there, oxygen, two oxygens are there. Then how to balance that one? There are so many methods are there to balance the equation. So one method, I'll just follow this one, which will be very familiar one. Right? I'll write down the which are the reactants and how many atoms are there. On the right hand side also, how many products are atoms, product atoms are present there. So on the left hand side, magnesium is there and oxygen is there. Right? So magnesium in the reactant side, and here it is a product. Okay. So magnesium, only one is there, oxygen two atoms. I hope it is clear. Then on the product side, one magnesium is there, oxygen is also one. We can see that magnesium is one and one. What about oxygen? Here two is there, here one is there. Then how to balance it? So first I will take the oxygen itself to balance that one. So what I will do? I will make it as a two. Now look here. Before going into that one, as you know that these are termed as a substrate, as I told you in the previous class, that is a previous session. These are the substrate which cannot be changed. Only thing is, the coefficient of that particular thing, it is going to be changed. So here, O2 it is there, here I cannot make it as a O2, as I told. So the coefficient for this one, what I am adding over here, it is a 2. So now here on the right hand side, when I write it like this, again after the changing that, if I write the magnesium and the oxygen itself, now you can see magnesium here it is a 1, oxygen on the reactant side it is a 2. Likewise on the product side, if you see, no, as it is a coefficient, it is a 2 magnesium and a 2 oxygen. Therefore magnesium it is a 2 and oxygen it is a 2. Now if you observe the equation carefully, now on the right hand side we have a 2 oxygen, it is balanced. What about the magnesium? 2 magnesium are there. So therefore what I do, the next step, that is a, I'll multiply, that is coefficient of a magnesium, I write it as a 2. Now if you observe 2 magnesium, 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen, now the reaction is, or equation is, balanced. I hope it is clear. So first what I did, I have balanced first the oxygen with the coefficient, that is multiplying by 2. So 2 it is, when it is balanced, oxygen is balanced. After, in the next step, I have balanced the magnesium by making, multiplying with the 2. I hope it is clear, children. I'll take one more example. Thank you. 21 and hydrogen is there and oxygen is there. Hydrogen how many are there? 2 are there and oxygen how many are there? It is only 1. On the product side if you observe, iron it is a 3, oxygen it is a 4, sorry, hydrogen it is a 2 and oxygen it is a 4. Okay, so this is exactly the condition of a reaction. So that means it is not at all balanced. You can see that iron it is a 1 and 3 over there. Only hydrogen by having 2 and 2, oxygen 1 and 4. So there is a need of a balancing of this equation. So the first step what I do, I will make the oxygen, here it is a 4, it is there. So here if I take the oxygen over here, I will make it as a 4. So the next equation what I will write, that is Fe plus H2O as it is, and Fe3O4 and H2 is there, I will add the 4 as a coefficient. I will add a coefficient as a 4 for hydrogen. So now if you see the reaction, here 4 oxygen, here 4 oxygen and hydrogen, if you observe, oxygen it is balanced, if you write down, okay. So Fe it is a 1, the hydrogen it is a 8 and oxygen it is a 4. And in the reactant side, in the product side, so Fe it is how much? 3 is there, oxygen it is 4, hydrogen it is a 2. You can see that oxygen it is balanced. Only we are going to remain in the hydrogen as well as the iron. So how to balance that one? So the next step what I am going to write here, as I have changed over here, I will take the hydrogen itself because already oxygen it is balanced. So I will take the hydrogen. So 4 into 2 it is. How much? 4 into 2. So how many altogether? 8. Altogether 8 hydrogen atoms are there. So what I will write up in the next step of our equation, that is a Fe plus 4H2O will give Fe3O4, and for this H2 as I have to make it as a balance, here it is a 8 is there and 2 is there. That means to make it as a 8, I have to multiply it with a 4. So coefficient what I am going to add here is a 4. I think now it is clear. So here it is a 4 into 2, that is a 8H and 4 into 2, 8H. Now we remain with the only the iron where it is a 1 here and it is a 3 here. So in the next step, what I am going to do? I am going to multiply this iron with the 3. So here, so the next step it is a 3 Fe plus 4H2O will give Fe3O4 plus 4H2. So this is the required, the balanced equation. I hope it is clear, children. So here are the 5 examples which I am going to give you as an assignment, which you are going to send it in the for the as an assignment for this exercise. Okay. So I hope you have understood how to balance the equation and what is the reason for balancing of a equation. Children, the thing is here though the simple they will look like a, but as you or sometimes you may feel it as a difficult also, but as you practice them you will come to know. As I have taken oxygen first as to for balancing, but you may think that many of the other element or atoms are there which can be balanced. So you are going to learn this balancing of an equation on the trial and error basis. So if you practice that one, so you will have a command over that balancing of an equation. So the next session, what we are going to learn about, it is about the types of a chemical reactions. As we have seen that many of the reactions which are going to occur in our surroundings, they are the best example for the, what you say, the different types of the chemical reactions. But we are going to see here in this session one by one. reactions. What I mean, I'll write out few of the examples over here on the board so that you will come to know. So whenever calcium oxide reacts with the water, or in other words, calcium oxide is commonly known as a quicklime. Okay, so when it is nothing but the normal chalk, what we people are going to for whitewash it off. So when it dissolves in the water, it's going to form a compound that is a calcium hydroxide. What is that one? Calcium hydroxide, which is also termed as or commonly known as a slaked lime. What it is known as a slaked lime. So when the quicklime is dissolved in the water, we're going to see that calcium hydroxide, this is a one product which is formed over there. Like when the simple one, that is a carbon plus oxygen, going to form CO2. I think if you observe this one, there is no need of a balancing of an equation. Carbon combining with the oxygen, that is it gets oxidized to form a carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. Likewise, you have a one more example, hydrogen and oxygen. So what it is going to form? H2O. That is nothing but the water. So if you observe this one, so few of the details I can write it over here. Here it is a liquid, and as it is a gas, and here it is a gas. So hydrogen in the gas is formed, oxygen also in the gas is formed. When they combine together, you are going to see that it's going to form a water in the liquid. If we observe in all the three reactions, okay, so all these are nothing but the reactants. Okay, and what are these? These are the products. And if we observe carefully, in all these equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3, the reactants are 2, right? And what about this one product which is formed over there? Only one product is formed. That means what? Reactants are more, but altogether they are going to form only one product. So what does it indicate? All is combined together and they are going to form only one product. So here it is, they are combining together only one product is, these are nothing but the type of a reaction which is termed as a combination reaction. What it is termed as a combination reaction. So what we understood by the combination reaction, if at all two or more than two different compounds or the elements combine together to form only one product, then it is termed as a combination reaction. I hope it is clear, children. So we will go for the next type of a reaction as a decomposition reaction.
H2O. That means what? It has got already the water molecule. required. And that energy is supplied in the form of a heat. So this is termed as that kind of a what we call decomposition, where the heat is involved. So this reaction is an example for thermal decomposition. I write it down. It is a thermal decomposition. I hope it is clear, children. Why we have to think about the energy is decomposition. more. And this is the cathode. So before going into that one, see, anode, it is a that thing which attracts the anion. Cathode, it is a that thing which attracts the cation. So cation, the positive charge one. Anion, it is a negatively charged one. As we know that here it is a, in case of this one, the gases go on collecting in such a way that, so the gases which is collected, it is a 1:2 proportion. By saying the gases collected over here, before, okay, what exactly will happen when the circuit is complete? We are going to see that water, after the electrolysis, it decomposes into hydrogen and the oxygen, H plus O minus. And these, what we call,
in case of water, we have seen two hydrogen and one oxygen. So in this decomposition, electricity acts as a decomposing energy. Hence, this is termed as a electrolytic decomposition. What it is termed as a electrolytic decomposition. That is a third type. So children, today we have learned that the decomposition reaction, combination reaction also we have learned decomposition reaction. In that one, the three types are there where energy is required: thermal, photolytic, and electrolytic. Thermal, it is using the heat energy to decompose that reactant. Photolytic means where the sunlight is going to decompose the reactant. And electrolytic, using the electricity, we are going to have a decomposition reaction. So that's all for this session, children. So next type of the reaction we are going to learn.